X-Men have done a lot since their first appearance in 1963, and they have done a lot of things that leave science behind.
Your body will go to sleep while your mind travels back in time.
But they have also made an effort to base their powers on actual genetic science. Let's look at what they've done well. The X gene. All mutants in X-Men have the X gene, which is located on the 23rd chromosome, which in real life is either a Y chromosome or, you guessed it, an X chromosome. I think we can safely assume that the writers put it on the X chromosome for branding, but it's actually good science too. If a person has two X chromosomes, they are biologically female. If they have an X and Y chromosome, they are biologically male. So if the X gene was located on the Y chromosome, only biological males could be mutants. But putting it on the X chromosome means that anyone can be a mutant. As we can see from the team's diversity, the writers chose the proper chromosome. Nice! But having a gene on the X chromosome has some implications for mutants. Like, a weird side effect is that there should be way more female mutants. Like, maybe twice as many? A biological male only has one X chromosome, so they only have one chance to inherit the X gene from their mother. But a biological female has two X chromosomes, one from each parent, so they have two chances to get the X gene. I am not aware of a huge gender imbalance, but it's also possible that many X genes are not noticeable. More on that in a minute. The X gene on the X chromosome also means that mutant powers cannot be passed from father to son. For every son, the father must pass on his Y chromosome, and the mother passes on an X chromosome. So all male mutants have a mother who carries the X gene, even if she doesn't know it. I went down a bit of a rabbit hole trying to identify father-son mutant pairs, and let's just say that in 60 years of stories, the X-Men family tree is really complicated. A third side effect of X chromosomes is that in rare cases where a biological female has two parents with X genes, she could inherit two different copies of the X gene. Having two copies could give two separate cycles of developing mutant powers, or it could make one very intense mutant power. So very powerful mutant females may have two X genes. And I think it's safe to say that some of the most powerful mutants ever have been female. In real life, genes on the X chromosome are called X-linked genes, and you just learned about them from a comic book. Gene expression. It's fun to see the adventures of these amazing mutants, but in real life, mutations happen all the time. You are a real-life mutant. So is everyone you know. So why aren't we flying around and firing energy blasts? Because the vast, vast majority of mutations do nothing. So a realistic reflection is that the majority of people in X-Men do not have mutant powers. It's possible they have the X gene, but when their X gene activates and starts mutating them, it gives them zero mutant powers. Or it gives them a mutant power which is unnoticeable, like the ability to listen to podcasts played at 1.5 speed and understand what they're saying. The X gene did its job, but not with an interesting result. Which is good because the vast majority of the mutations that do anything interesting do something bad. I liked how the X-Men TV show addressed this, with an underground society of mutants who have disfiguring mutations or gross powers. This reflects how the X gene would work in real life. Most mutations do nothing, and most of the rest are negative. Only a fraction of a fraction of X gene mutations would be useful. I think different gene expression clears up a lot of the family tree problems we alluded to earlier. Like, maybe a powerful mutant has two parents with X genes that did nothing noticeable. Gene repression. Genes can be expressed differently at different times, like, for example, how the X gene works. When the X gene activates, cell machinery starts reading the genetic code. The X gene codes for a set of proteins, just like normal genes, so the cell starts making proteins, presumably X proteins, but they're never called that. X proteins bind to other parts of the DNA molecule, causing mutations and leading to a cascade of effects that vary by person. Sometimes the X gene starts to work before birth, like in Beast, who was born with his mutant appearance. But the typical expression of the X gene is that it starts around adolescence, during times of stress. This is great biology and something that happens in real life. Cells have many ways to regulate gene expression. Let's look at one way called repressor proteins. The cell makes proteins with a specific job. These proteins find a certain sequence of DNA and stick to it. The repressor protein sits in the way, preventing that DNA from being read by other cellular machinery, making the gene inactive. Interestingly, repressors can also have a key molecule, which turns them on and off. If the key is present, the repressor deactivates and moves out of the way, which in turn activates the gene. So back to X-Men. What key molecule might cause the X gene to turn on during adolescence, during stressful situations? I looked at a big list of human hormones. They all have problems as single causes. Progesterone was looking good because it rises during adolescence in all humans and also rises during times of stress. But newborn babies have very high levels of progesterone, so their X genes should activate immediately. It doesn't line up with the facts as we know them. Clearly, it's more complicated. Maybe more than one factor is involved. Perhaps an X factor. My guess is something like progesterone plus a biological clock that delays expression in most cases. Over their long history, X-Men have taught us a lot of things, mostly about how cool it would be to fly around and shoot energy blasts, but also about how society can deal with conflict and discrimination. And it turns out, a little bit about biology too. I hope you enjoyed this experimental journey through movie biology. Let me know if you'd like to see more videos like this in the comments. There are a ton of videos about actual animal biology on this channel, and you can subscribe to know when a new video comes out. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.